This is the Lian Hydroshift II LCD-CR, the latest and one of the flashiest all-in-one CPU coolers Lian has ever released. And if looks could kill, we'd be hydro-shifting our way into the afterlife. But since its RGB and LCD bling doesn't come cheap, does this AIO have the performance to shift its way onto your shopping list, or is this one best left on the shelf? We have the answers to all of these questions right here, right now on Robeytech. There is no denying it. Lian Li's got game, and they have more than a few products designed that have shaped the landscape for PC aesthetics. The all-in-one dynamic case launched dual-chamber, fishbowl-style cases into the mainstream, and just last year, we were seriously impressed by its flashier, younger sibling, the 011 Evo RGB, which you can see for yourself right here. In a similar way, the Hydroshift II LCD-CR fits right into Lian Li's design language and the disco rave vibe that all of the RGB creates. So with cases and coolers, Lian Li creates some killer looks by keeping things in-house if you're building a showcase PC. They say never to judge a book by its cover, but that's genuinely hard to do here, especially when you see it in a full build. Book, consider yourself judged, and we deem you worthy when it comes to aesthetics. And Lian Li is banking heavily on aesthetics with this AIO with a similar approach to what they took with the original Hydroshift 360. The fans are pre-installed and the hoses are braided and pre-routed through special brackets to get rid of the excess tubing that might clutter up your case. While this AIO may be a looker, if a PC looks good but overheats, it actually isn't a good PC at all. It's a bit of a diva. And when we consider the high price of the Hydroshift 2, we really have to wonder if this is just the cost of beauty or if this is even the right option for us or you. But before we get into any of that, we'd like to thank Lian Li for sending over the Hydroshift 2 for review today. Let's get to know the Hydroshift 2, starting with the pricing. On the surface, the Hydroshift 2 looks the part of a premium product. While it's not the most expensive AIO out there, it's hardly what most people would consider cheap. The Hydroshift 2 is available in 360 with three different variants, the 360 TL, the 360 CL, and the 360 NL. The 360 TL version is the flagship model and has the highest performance Lian Li Uni Fan TL fans. That model comes in at around $240. The 360 CL version swaps the fans and drops airflow between 20 and 30%, but will only set you back $180. Or if you prefer to bring your own fans, the 360 NL is an option for only $160. For our review, we're looking at the CL model, which we'll be referring to as the Hydroshift 2 for the rest of the review. With the Hydroshift 2's pricing landing around $180, it faces stiff competition from some of the best brands in the business. Between the $180 and $200 price point, we have the Corsair IQ Link Titan 360 RX RGB and the Fantex Glacier 1 D30, as well as last generation's Hydroshift 360R and 360S. It is worth noting that, with the exception of the older Hydroshifts, none of these models feature an LCD screen. So with the Hydroshift 2, you'll be getting a stunner of an AIO with a display, but does it come at a cost beyond dollars? Let's keep digging. Moving on to installation and compatibility, the Hydroshift 2 certainly looks futuristic, but it doesn't waste time looking too far back with socket support. In fact, if you're on Team Blue, you'll find that it supports LGA 1851 and, thanks to backward compatibility, LGA 1700. That means that it only supports back to Intel's 12th generation and up to its current line of Core Ultra 200S processors. Support isn't much different on the AMD side, as the Hydroshift 2 supports both AM4 and AM5 sockets. However, with the incredible socket life that AMD has offered with the Ryzen platform, that means that the Hydroshift 2 will work with everything from 1000 series onward. But if you're still running a Ryzen 1000 or 2000 series, why not Hydroshift your way into something more modern like we did with these recent build videos? While you're there, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell so you can enjoy content like this as it drops. And for extra PC building goodness, why don't you head over to Robeytech Live for even more content to enjoy. Now moving on to installation, things can get a bit tricky, even if you're an experienced builder. For Intel, you'll need to use the usual bracket that attaches to the back of the motherboard, so you'll have an additional step. But even for AMD, you'll need to remove the mounting clips that came pre-installed in your motherboard and use the set that Lian Li gave you. That's because the brackets that snap onto the pump head need to slide into a special channel before being fastened down in all four corners. Well, having four mounting points is something we do love to see because it obviously lowers the likelihood of uneven mounting, Lian Li needs to go back to the drawing board with this like slide bracket. In theory, fitting the pump head into the bracket should simplify getting it aligned with its mounting points. However, we found it only made things more complicated and it introduced a failure point that didn't need to be there. Imagine you need to slide the pump head along a channel, all while trying not to smear the thermal paste underneath. Depending on your application method and how much of an accidental shove you might give it, you could wind up with an uneven application of paste making its way off of your CPU and onto the socket or the motherboard itself. Now, if you can get this right, the rest of the installation process isn't difficult, but it is more limited and requires more planning ahead of time. Also, because of the way the hoses run into the channel on the right side of the radiator, there's only enough length available to mount the Hydroshift 2 on the top of your case, unless you want to completely remove, which is kind of getting rid of the key feature. But that's not all. Hiding the hoses along the radiator requires an additional mounting point on a rail for 140mm fans. This does move the assembly closer to your motherboard and could cramp an already tight workspace. Whatever you do, plug in your CPU header first, otherwise you may be left making a blood sacrifice with your scraped knuckles. All that's left is sweat and tears, which might also accompany the process as well, let's just be honest. From there, managing the wires is mostly pretty standard, but we found that the USB cable was just a little bit too short to properly hide. Without providing your own extension cable, you essentially need to run it right through the directly, like the inside of the case, undermining some of those really good looks. Now that we have the ins and outs of taking the Hydroshift in and out of your system, let's take a closer look at what makes it tick. The Hydroshift 2, we're testing features of trio of 120mm fans that can reach a top speed of 2200 RPM. That equates to 72 CFM and 3.0 mmH2O of static pressure to force air through the density of the radiator fins and exhaust that heat out of your case. And if those aren't big enough numbers for you, Lian does offer the TL version with around 25% more airflow and 32% more static pressure. We haven't had the chance to test this one out for ourselves, so how big of a temperature difference that works out to be is up for debate until we can test it out here in the studio. The pump, on the other hand, is the same across every variant and is pretty standard outside of its 500 nit IPS display. It's rated to run between 2200 and 2500 RPM, and Lian warranties its performance for 6 years along with other components, so you can be confident that it's up for long-term use. Moving on to the radiator, it wears its tricks on its sleeve. The hidden hoses and wireless fans rightfully garner the attention, but on close inspection, it's a fairly typical design made of aluminum and using single wave fins. It will mount to any typical 360mm radiator, but bear in mind that you'll need a 140mm mount as well to attach its Heidi hose. Or is it a Heidi hose holder? Anyway, you'll need a 140mm mount for whatever that is. Hey, so Roby from the future jumping back to the past because we forgot to cover the screen. So before we dive into how the Hydroshift 2 performed, let's take a second to talk about its LCD because it's gotten a facelift since the last generations. It features the same 480 by 480 resolution, but this time in a smaller 2.1 inch screen size. While this might sound like a downgrade at first, a lot of that reduction is because Lian has gone for a circular design instead of a block shape like the original. They've also added a bright RGB ring around the outside, making it more customizable and I feel like more worthy of a showcase gaming PC. And given it's a 60 Hz refresh rate, it means smooth animations. Like most CPU coolers with LCD screens, you can customize the Hydroshift 2's display using their L-Connect software, but cool enough, it's actually optional if you'd rather avoid it. Lian has a range of different presets built in so you can cycle through by turning the pump head like a knob. This basically displays basic system information like your temperature and fan speed on different animated backgrounds. And you know what? They don't look bad, but if you want full control, first thing you'll need to do is connect it via USB, and then you'll need to turn to Lian L-Connect 3 software. With this app, you can customize its different modes, upload your own GIFs, or even play full-blown MP4 videos. Now, by the way, the Hydroshift 2 is also wireless compatible with Lian L wireless controller, so you can quickly sync up lighting presets and fan speeds without worrying about physically wiring everything together. But if you want the full meal deal, you gotta connect it all the way. While the Hydroshift 2 has a decent spec and looks to kill, can it keep CPU temps as stone cold? As a reminder, all of our testing is done on like-for-like systems representing mainstream rigs for both Intel and AMD. For Intel, we use the Core i7-14700K, and for AMD, that's a Ryzen 7 7700X. The other components are evenly matched, and we run the same battery of tests on both, so you can make the best decision no matter which team claims your allegiance. Let's kick things off with Intel, but as you'll soon see, the story this cooler tells is pretty much the same across both platforms, which I think is a good thing. At idle, the Hydroshift 2 landed right in the middle of our charts at just under 28 degrees Celsius. That's about half a degree cooler than the more expensive Corsair IQ Link Titan 360, and a little over a degree warmer than the Fractal Lumen S36, which both of these are the Hydroshift 2's price competitors. Overall, the Hydroshift 2 falls right in the middle of the data we've gathered on idle temp, so there's nothing terribly remarkable here. In our CPU load testing, however, average temps for the Hydroshift 2 kind of cratered, leaving the AIO with an average just above 84 degrees Celsius. This placed it within a degree of the Corsair IQ Link Titan 360 and about 2 degrees from the H150i RGB. Collectively, these three coolers are the hottest we've tested under load on our Intel rig. But when we look at Cinebench, its score also wasn't all that hot, landing in the bottom five. Those results are kind of rough, but what about power draw? Overall, the Hydroshift consistently drew a higher wattage than most other AIOs in our archive. At idle, it's in the bottom third, drawing just over 6 watts, but under load and while gaming, it drops to the bottom three with an average power draw of just over 243 watts during CPU load testing and just under 106 watts while gaming. Turning to our gaming performance, the Hydroshift 2 shifts its way into last place with an average temperature of nearly 57 degrees Celsius. That's within 5 degrees of the competition for Corsair and Fractal, but it's significantly worse than the last generation Hydroshift 360S and 360 TL. That being said, while these results aren't impressive in comparison to other AIOs, they aren't likely to be a problem in most builds. Remember, gaming isn't as taxing as heavier workloads, and around 57 degrees Celsius is well within thermal limits for an Intel CPU. Moving on to our 7700X system, the Hydroshift 2 lands dead last for our idle temps, smack in the middle between 39 and 40 degrees Celsius. It did better under load, averaging just under 88 degrees Celsius and coming closer to the middle of the pack than at the end. But that grace was short-lived because when we put it through Cinebench's thermal benchmark, it was again taking up the rear with a score of 19,455. Power draw tells a similar tale with its average result. At idle, it drew a comparatively high load at around 31 watts, but returned very middle of the road results under load, pulling just over 144 watts. Gaming again landed it as the worst in our roster, however, pulling in just under 80 watts under average. Did it perform any better in gaming than it did on our Intel test bench? Across multiple tests, we recorded an average temp of just over 56 degrees, which again places it dead last in our lineup. But if all you're doing is gaming, you really don't have much to be concerned about since even the last place result is so far below TJ Maxx. With performance on the table, what does this mean for noise levels under load, and are the fans working hard or are they hardly working? You guys have spoken, we've listened, and noise testing is now a normal part of our test routine. And when it comes to how Lian Li has tuned these fans, its performance is a bit mixed. With the fans running at 50% speed, it's actually one of the quieter AIOs we've tested at just over 48 decibels. Running at full speed, which you're likely to hit running heavier workloads, it jumped to the second loudest at a hair under 67 decibels. What does this mean in real world terms? When you're doing lightweight to like your moderately heavy tasks, like your gaming, streaming, or editing photos, you probably won't notice fan noise. Overall, 48 decibels is quiet enough that it will blend in with your other case fans. When the going gets tough though, however, you're probably gonna hear these fans more than others. Though, how much they'll stand out really depends on the fan curve of your case fans. With everything running full blast, these still might blend in, just like you probably tune out your refrigerator or the sounds of a shower running, which are similar comparisons to both recorded noise levels. So more than likely, you'll be able to pick out its trio of disco-loving air movers from the rest, but they shouldn't be too annoying. All right, so with all that in mind, how does the Hydroshift 2's value proposition stack up? We rank all the coolers we test by their overall value using a formula that allows us to balance thermal results with the actual pricing. Here is the fancy math. Its CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, minus the CPU temperatures under load, when we divide those numbers by the retail price. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare. In this case, with a price of around $180, its performance is pretty middle of the pack with a score of 11.4. Ironically, the Hydroshift 2 lands right in between the two versions of the original Hydroshift, kind of like Lian Li shifted into neutral instead of high gear this time around. If you put looks higher on the priority list, this could be worth the price for you, but if you're after low temps or you have your eye on overclocking, this may not be the best choice for your CPU. With all the testing out of the way, where do we land on the Hydroshift 2 LCD-CR? For us, it all comes down to what you value the most. Are you the type of person that values look over performance? I mean, the Hydroshift 2 is a great looking AIO, but beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Though this AIO is kind of like one of those one-eyed beholders from Dungeons and Dragons, it's intriguing to look at, but staring at it for too long could be your downfall if you're trying to use this AIO for overclocking. Honestly, when we reviewed all of the data and the challenges with the installation as a team, this was one of those instances where you had to take a step back and ask a few guiding questions. Can this AIO keep a CPU cool for tasks like gaming, video editing, productivity, and more? Well, even though we saw higher temperatures on both Intel and AMD, 80 degrees is not putting your CPU in danger, nor were we running into thermal throttling. So yes, you can use it for editing, gaming, and more. Is it going to be inside Splave's next world championship overclocking rig? Heck no. Should you try to overclock with it? Probably not. But unless you're living on the surface of the sun or in Arizona, the Hydroshift 2 is going to work just fine. Next question, are there benefits to this AIO for some people? If you're trying to build a super clean build with well-manicurable cables and hoses? Absolutely. It's hard to imagine anyone not finding the Hydroshift 2 downright gorgeous, especially with its signature style. This AIO carries on the Hydroshift legacy from the last generation, which, if you want to see how to install one, we have an actual helpful guide right here. So self-referencing aside, back to the question, are there better performing AIOs out there? Of course there are. There will always be products that dethrone strong performers or offer something different. But that doesn't cancel the reality that for most people out there, this performs more than well enough. And finally, is there a reason why we shouldn't recommend this AIO? No. To be clear, there are considerations with this AIO that we've mentioned through this video, which could potentially impact performance and installation fit. However, armed with enough knowledge, patience, and videos like this one, you already know where the pitfalls are and you can avoid them. At the end of the day, the Hydroshift is, it's kind of spinning a lot of plates. It's trying to keep a balance between looks, performance, and ease of use. That installation plate, it's a little bit more wobbly than we like it. Its performance is adequate for most, and its looks, man, that thing's just spinning. They're just stunning. And so far, nothing's crashed down. So unless you fall into the camp of overclockers who are pushing their CPUs to the limits regularly, or you just can't top mount a radiator in your PC case, there are few AIOs that look as pretty as this one. And that'll do it for this video and where we land with the Lian Hydroshift 2 LCD-CR. A stunning cooler with above average temps and a little bit of a tricky installation. But we wanna know what you think. Is it worth sacrificing performance to have a PC slick enough to make your friends stop and take notice? Like, ooh, wow. Do you like where Lian has been going with the cable routing? And what do you think about the sliding installation? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this, either here at Robeytech or also over at Robeytech Live. And if you wanna continue the conversation, maybe you wanna know if this is the right AIO for you, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts who love to make comments about these very same things. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, follow us on all your other favorite social media platforms at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you made it this far, thank you for sticking with me for this long. We'll see you on the next video.